good evening. You can be seated. Good evening and welcome to the 48th annual commencement of Herkimer County Community College. My name is Isabella Crandall, Chairwoman of the Board of Trustees. We are pleased you have joined us this evening to celebrate the class of 2016. At this time, please turn off your cell phones and keep them off for the remainder of the ceremony. Thank you. We extend our warmest welcome to all of our guests watching in the Sarkis Bush Theater, the television viewing audience watching us on HCTV, and our guests viewing the college's webcast of commencement. Please stand for the national anthem, sung by Communication Arts Music Industry Majors. Emily Shinsky, and accompanied by adjunct music instructor Ann Kakuba. Offered by Victor Lukusik, Indian pastor at Whitesboro Presbyterian Church and also a member of the class of 2016.
I promise you won't get too tired. Let us pray. Spirit of God, I have prayed and talked with you in public many times. However, this time it is deeply personal. Today I am truly honored to be a member of the class of 2016 from Herkimer College. My wife Lori is here to celebrate with me today. My mom and other friends and family members are streaming this evening live. My classmates, all of people who mean so much to them, we remember family and friends, and are thankful for them. There are 8 young women who are my fellow travel majors that were in every travel class with me. The students who sit in the chairs in this gym all have made special bonds in this place. Thank you for friendships created on this hill. The back rows are filled with good teachers. Graduates who walk across the stage all have their own mentors and special and meaningful professors. We are grateful for the fabulous instructors who have taught us. for athletic teams and contests, mocktails, fairs, events, and performances, for common spaces of classrooms and halls, the cafeteria, playing fields, gyms, living spaces, quads, and the general, for all those things which support and build community, which are uniquely Herkimer, we thank you, O God. Herkimer has provided us with a great experience. We have had access to great resources for learning. We have met and shared with good people. We know great joy. Rock on, Herkimer 2016. We ask all these things in the name of all those who have gone before. Amen.
Please be seated. On behalf of the trustees, the faculty and staff of Herkimer County Community College, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you. I would like to introduce members of the Board of Trustees here this evening and ask them to stand as their names are called. Mr. Robert Blanchley, our Vice Chairman from Herkimer. Secretary of the Board, Mr. Michael Testa of Frankfort. Dr. Mark Ainsworth of Herkimer. Mr. William Gregory of Frankfort. Ms. Joan Perez of Illinois. Mr. Jeff Roche of Louisville. And our student trustee, Ms. Ryan Steele from Little Falls. Please welcome our elected officials on the dais. We have Bernard Pekwinski, Sr., Chairman of the Herkimer County Legislature. Assemblyman Mark Butler. Assemblywoman Claudia Tenney. And also members of the college, faculty, and administration. We have the President of the Academic Senate, Associate Professor Jeffrey Steele. Faculty Representative and Associate Professor of Business, Catherine Loretta, who is retiring after 35 years of service. Linda Cantillo-Rome, Associate Dean of Academic Affairs. Aaron Kramer, Associate Dean of Academic Affairs, Business, Health, Science, and the Technology Division. Dr. Robin Vitell Riker, Associate Dean of Academic Affairs, Humanities and Social Science Division. Michael Oriolo Provost. Dr. Matthew Halls, Dean of Students. President Kathleen Colgan, who is completing her first year as president of Herkimer County. I would like also to recognize a few special guests in our audience. Herkimer County is our college sponsor. And in addition to our chairman, Mr. Pablinski, on the dais, we have tonight with us legislator Peter Meyer from Frankfort. Representing the Herkimer County College Foundation Board is Mr. Stephen Smith, and thank you for your support of Herkimer College. Also with us this evening is the incoming president of the SUNY Student Assembly and student trustee, Mark Cohen. And former Herkimer College president, Anne Lamar, who retired in 2014, and thank you for joining us. I would like to invite Mr. Peplinski to now deliver greetings.
Thank you. Graduates, it is an honor to welcome the 2016 graduating class of Herkimer County Community College. This ceremony recognizes your effort to better yourself and your community. Noting this effort, we acknowledge the support provided by your parents, spouses, family, friends, and faculty. We thank them. Just a short aside, my grandson William is a member of this graduating class, and discussing the ceremony, his advice was short, direct, and sit down. If only I could be as succinct. But I will take his advice. Just a short closing comment. Extending this welcome to you graduates and those supporting your journey does not end today. The college and Herkimer County hope you will always feel you are a part of our community. You will always be welcome at the college and in our county. Congratulations and the best of everything in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Peplinski, and we appreciate the continued support of the county legislature. Now, please welcome Assemblyman Mark Butler from the 118th Assembly District.
Thank you very much, Isabella. It's a pleasure to join you here tonight, and I'm certainly pleased to add my congratulations to all of the graduates here this evening. Of course, we are glad you are going out into the world, but we are also a little bit saddened that many of you will be leaving Herkimer. I trust you have enjoyed your time here while you have completed your studies. I would be remiss if I did not join you, by the way, in wishing the best for your baseball and softball teams in their tournaments. They're following in the rich tradition of championships that we have established here at Herkimer College, and you only need to look at all those wonderful banners in the back here. Now, the news at this point is not particularly good, but I'm sure we will prevail. As a member of the Assembly's Higher Education Committee, I take particular pride in the accomplishments of Herkimer College and its students. Wherever I go, it seems, Herkimer graduates speak to me highly of their times here in the beautiful campus on the Hill. As a state legislator, it is one of my duties to see that the mission of our SUNY colleges is maintained. And that, of course, is to offer a quality education at a reasonable cost. It's a cooperative effort with our local sponsor, Herkimer County. I am pleased to share with you the fact that the state legislature this year increased community college base aid by $100 per student. We set aside $3 million for a community college apprenticeship program in cooperation with local employers. And probably for some of you, the most important, we continued funding for childcare costs. And finally, although you do have a beautiful campus here, an institution is only as good as its people. You have been blessed with a great faculty and staff here at Herkimer. And I must congratulate your board on their wise choice for president, Dr. Kathleen Colgan. Yes. In a few short months, she has already left her stamp on Herkimer, and I foresee much greater things in the future for her and this college. Again, congratulations to you all. And thanks for sharing a part of your life with us.
Thank thank you for your ongoing support of Herkimer College, Assemblyman Butler. Now please welcome Assemblywoman Claudia Tenney, who represents the 101st Assembly District.
Thank you. It's an honor to be here with you today. My honor to be here with your new president, who's completing her first year, your faculty, staff, and I just want to say thank you to everyone around the room who's a parent, a grandparent, a brother, a sister, a family member, or just a friend, because without you, our graduates wouldn't be here today. Without your support and your support of their academic success in being graduates here today, so I just want to say thank you to you. Also to the students, this is your day. Be proud of what you've accomplished. I look back, I graduated 33 years ago. Hard to believe, isn't it? But it was one of the greatest days of my life, and I really enjoyed it, and make the most of this day. And I just wanted to share with you a couple of quick things. I remember the graduation speech from 33 years ago, and I just wanted to impart a couple of things on you. I had the distinct honor of having the former president of Notre Dame University, Father Theodore Hesburgh, was one of our convocation speaker in my college. He passed away last year at age of 97. But he did say to us, he gave us a couple of things to remember. As college students, you've been through a lot in your last week. You're in a room, you're all waving your programs because it's very hot. But remember a couple of things as you venture forth into the world. And one of those things that Father Hesburgh said were the three C's. Be competent at whatever field you choose to be in. Be committed to that field. Have compassion, especially towards your fellow man in whatever profession you're seeking. And I added my own two C's, sort of a part of what I've been through in my odyssey, in my life, in my career. And I've been blessed by many things, but I've also had a career, a very short time in politics. But two things I think stand out, and two C's I'd like to add to Father Hesburgh's C's. And one of those things is always maintain your character. Never compromise your integrity. And the final thing, and I think it's the key to success and the glue to all the C's, is have courage. Go forth, stand for what you believe in. Never let anyone tell you you can't do something, and believe in yourself. And you will be successful because you come from a wonderful university with a great program. And I just want to say the last C is congratulations.
Thank you, Assemblywoman Tenney. It is my pleasure to now introduce the President of the Student Government Association and Student Trustee, Ms. Rhiannon Steele.
Thank you. So throughout the year, I've given numerous speeches about getting involved and how important it is for students to venture outside their comfort zones. Many of you may have taken that advice and gotten involved in some way on campus, and you may not have even realized it. Remember, getting involved can mean joining a club or going to a game with a friend. I want to thank all of you who took that advice and congratulate you on the new friendships and relationships that you've made because of it. We can all admit that these relationships played a role in getting us in these very seats. Our fellow students accomplished a lot this year, so here's a few highlights. The fashion students worked with the foundation to establish a scholarship. Clubs and athletic teams participated in various community service projects. School records were broken and All-American recognitions were earned. Amnesty International wrote letters advocating for various human rights at their annual Jamnesty event. And in this year's Fayathon, talented students were recognized for their writing and artwork. These are just a few examples of the things students at Herkimer have achieved and things we have done to help our community. Someone recently said to me, "Don't forget to thank someone who was there for you." In fact, there are many people in our lives that have played a role in getting us here today. Take a look around you. I guarantee you will find several people in this gym that have supported you. It may be your parents, your family, your friends, your teammates, your advisors, professors, or a coach. Thank them for being a part of your amazing journey and supporting you along the way. Most importantly, take a minute to reflect and acknowledge all of your hard work. Be proud of this moment. Like General Nicholas Herkimer, whose courageous acts inspired his army to forge ahead, you too are a Herkimer general. Being a general means choosing civility and working your hardest to accomplish a goal. It means supporting your community and working your absolute hardest to achieve your dreams. Getting involved and working hard is never easy. I challenge you to take these skills and experiences with you to the next college, job, or on your next adventure. Let's show the world how amazing we really are. If Herkimer students continue to encourage others to do something more, we can inspire the world to be generals too. Congratulations, guys. We did it.
Thank you, Rhiannon, and best wishes to you. It is my pleasure to introduce this evening's student speaker, Ms. Teddy Cromling, a social science major from Ilion, New York. Her speech is titled, We Are Seeds.
On behalf of the graduating class of 2016, I would like to say hello and thank you to the faculty, staff, and honored guests for being here today. I would also like to thank the family and friends who supported each and every one of us. Patrice Vachon said, to give thanks is to recognize what has come to you. How does the seed give thanks? It flowers. I love to work outside in my garden. My most favorite thing to do is plant seeds and watch as their tops pop out of the ground. Each and every passing thought that we have, good or bad, is a seed. We can leave our seeds in the package, or we can take them out and plant them. And just like a seed that has been planted, growth of a thought is only seen when we nurture it. When we think about the things we experience, we are nurturing our seeds of knowledge, and we see our growth through the people around us. When I came to Herkimer College, I was a dormant seed smothered by weeds. I was a 46-year-old recently divorced woman with a minimum wage job, living on the hope that I could survive another day. I was afraid of what may lay ahead of me because I was not a very good high school student. I was lucky to have graduated. Many years later, I was walking onto a college campus full of young people. I was afraid I would not be accepted. But I needed the sunlight, water, and fertilizer, which only a college education could provide, before my green top would burst through the hard, compact soil. My first semester here was the weeding I desperately needed. Beginning to think and write and tell people about the things I had read and learned was the bright sunlight that I had needed to encourage further growth. My roots were starting to grow and expand, but there were still some weeds in the way, so I changed my major to liberal arts social sciences so that I can concentrate on English courses. That change became the water and fertilizer I needed to burst from beneath the soil. Every instructor I had played a part in my being able to see above the dirt surrounding me. Learning to have an open mind, open to every spoken word, to every action made, open to life and learning, has shown me how to love who I am, who I will become, and how I want to get there. Once my little green top burst through the soil, there was no stopping my leaves from unfurling. My mother has told me all of my life that if you are going to do something, do it right or don't do it at all. And with that root system in place, I decided to completely embrace the college experience by getting involved in extracurricular activities. I graduated as the co-president of the Student Activities Committee, a student ambassador, and treasurer of the student government. I was also a member of the History Club, and I served as the Gaming Club secretary. I had found that age is not the boundary that I had made it out to be. I had bloomed with vibrant flowers that started to shed pollen that inspired ideas for myself and the college. I plan on continuing to shed my pollen by furthering my education and becoming an English instructor. I have enjoyed the sunlight of Herkimer College so much that I want to be sunlight for others who may be struggling to break the surface of their future. I encourage you to do your absolute best. Not just today, but for the rest of your life. Scatter your seeds of knowledge and let the wisdom of the knowledge that you gain carry your seeds across the world. Be involved in life, interact with people, do whatever inspires you. Do not lay stagnant. I want us to grow, to change, and to become the big and beautiful flowering plant that we know we are. Congratulations to all of us. We are graduating! Thank you.
Thank you, Teddy. It is my pleasure to again introduce the president of Herkimer College, Dr. Kathleen McColgan, to present this evening's special awards and recognitions.
Thank you, Chairwoman Crandall. The achievement students do not
can't speak.
The achievement of our students do not happen without the dedication and support of our faculty and staff. At this time, I would like to ask that all our faculty and staff stand and be recognized. Please. For all that you do, for our students, and for our institution, I thank you. Thank you. You may note that some of our graduates, in addition to their caps and gowns, have accessories that signify special achievements. Today, graduates wearing gold honor stoles have achieved high honors with a cumulative grade point average of 3.8 and above, or highest honor with a 4.0 GPA as of December 2015. The double cords that are golden in color signify successful completion of the college's honors program. Graduates who are members in good standing of Phi Theta Kappa, the International Honor Society for Junior Colleges, are wearing blue and gold cords. And graduates who are veterans of the United States Armed Forces are wearing red, white, and blue cords. Thank you for your service to our country. We are very proud of the achievements of these students, and I would like to ask all of our graduates wearing gold stoles or cords to stand and be recognized. Herkimer College is proud of the cultural diversity that our international students bring to our student body. And we proudly, on the platform today, have the flags that represent the countries of all our international students. thank you for bringing and enriching our campus community. The highest award a faculty or staff member can receive is the State University of New York Chancellor's Award for Excellence. This award provides system-wide recognition for superior professional achievement and encourages the ongoing pursuit of excellence among faculty and staff. Through these awards, SUNY publicly proclaims its pride in the accomplishment and personal dedication of its instructional faculty, librarians, and professional staff across its campuses. To date, a total of 60 Herkimer College faculty and staff have been honored with this award. Each wears the SUNY Medallion, which will be awarded today to our 2016 Chancellor's Award recipients. I now ask that all previous recipients of the Chancellor's Award for Excellence please stand to be recognized. Thank you. It is my pleasure to announce the recipient of the 2016 SUNY Chancellor's Award for Professional Service, Tabitha Carter, Coordinator for the Internet Academy. Ms. Carter has been an outstanding member of our college community for 16 years. She began her career at Herkimer as an application support technician, then served as technical assistant for client service in the Internet Academy for 12 years. And in 2014, she was promoted to coordinator for the Internet Academy. Tabitha provides our students, faculty, and staff with the highest quality of service. Her commitment to excellence is a defining characteristic of her work. She is actively engaged in our campus community through her leadership roles on committees and special initiatives, including professional development and technical assistance trainings conducted through our Teaching and Learning Collaborative. At the SUNY system level, she has served on the Open SUNY Learning Management System Administrators Committee and on the Open SUNY Advisory Council. Ms. Carter has also been named an Open SUNY Fellow in recognition of her excellence in designing online course delivery. Congratulations, Tabitha, on your SUNY Chancellor's Award for Excellence in Professional Service. Professor Devitt, would you please join me? Assistant Professor of English, Andrew Devitt, is a recipient of the SUNY Chancellor's Award for Excellence in Teaching. Mr. Devitt has served the academic mission of our institution with excellence for more than 15 years. Professor Devitt leads by example, establishing a highly effective classroom environment that is serious and rigorous in regard to its subject, but also encouraging for all students' input. His gift as an educator lies in his ability to provide each of his students with individual attention and support. His ability to reach his students on both an intellectual and personal level is evidenced by the fact that so many of his students continue to stay in touch with him and to discuss writing with him even after they have completed his class. Mr. Devitt also focuses a great deal of time and energy on organizing and supporting extracurricular activities for students interested in creative writing. He founded and serves as advisor of the Writing Club and is a faculty advisor for our award-winning campus literary magazine, Phaethon. He has been an active participant in the college's effort to develop an effective process of academic assessment. His commitment to continuous improvement and the collaborative spirit he brings to work are further testament to his quality as an educator. And I am proud to present Professor Andrew Devitt with the 2016 SUNY Chancellor's Award for Excellence in Teaching. Congratulations. The State University of New York also recognizes student excellence with the prestigious SUNY Chancellor's Award for Student Excellence. This award recognizes students who have best demonstrated the integration of academic excellence with accomplishments in the areas of leadership, athletics, community service, creative and performing arts, campus involvement, or career achievement. Two, Herkimer County Community College students were among the 248 recipients from 64 campuses to be selected for this year's award. Our first Chancellor's Award honoree is Timothy McKenzie. Tim is a liberal arts and sciences general studies major from Islip, New York, Central Islip, New York. He has served as a resident assistant, admissions tour guide, peer tutor, member of the judicial review board, and member of the men's basketball team. As a resident assistant, Tim sponsored the first Herkimer College dance battle and hosted a dating domestic violence forum for students. He is an advocate for breast cancer awareness, volunteering his time with the basketball team last fall to raise funds for this very cause. Tim has excelled academically, is a strong campus leader, and a wonderful role model for his peers. Tim is preparing to participate in a six-month internship with Sunrise Kindergarten and Whitestone High School in Beijing, China, where he will coordinate student activities and teach American culture. Upon completion of his internship, Tim plans to attend Clarkson University on a leadership transfer scholarship to study innovation and entrepreneurship. Please join me in congratulating Timothy McKenzie. Lindsay Paris, a science major from Herkimer, is also a recipient of the SUNY Chancellor's Award for Excellence. Lindsay is unable to be with us this evening as she, along with her fellow teammates, are in Rochester, Minnesota with the softball team competing for a national championship. Lindsay is a member of the Phi Theta Kappa International Honor Society, an honors program graduate, and a captain of the softball team. She has participated in a variety of volunteer activities, including the Graham Lauren Adopt a Child for Christmas program, the American Heart Association's Heart, Run, and Walk, and youth softball clinics. Lindsay has accepted an athletic and academic scholarship to Division II Mercyhurst University in Erie, Pennsylvania. Please join me in congratulating Lindsay. The SUNY Chancellor's Scholar Athlete Award recognizes a combination of high achievement in academics and athletics. To be considered for this award, student athletes were nominated by their campus athletic directors. Nominees' academic credentials and athletic accomplishments were then reviewed by a panel of athletic directors from across the SUNY system, along with members of the SUNY Provost's Office. This year, only 78 students from across the state's 64 campuses were honored with this award. I'm going to say that again. Only 78 students from across the 64 campuses were honored. And Herkimer, we have two. Nicole Doolin, would you please stand? Nicole is a science major from Frankfort, New York. She helped the women's soccer team win the Region 3 championship in both years she started for the Generals. The 2015 team finished third at the national tournament, outscoring opponents 73-6 in 20 total games. Nicole was a Mountain Valley All-Conference member both years, a second team All-Region selection in 2014, and first team All-Region selection in 2015. She helped the program to a 32-6 overall record in 2 years, scoring 8 goals and 13 assists. Nicole will be continuing her education at Lemoyne College in the fall. Please join me in congratulating Nicole. And finally, I would like to recognize Patrick Dorian, a liberal arts and science general studies major from Kingston, New York. Patrick is unable to be here this evening as the baseball team is competing in the Region 3 tournament. As a freshman, Pat was named All-American for his stellar play by helping the baseball team to a school record with 48 wins and a third place finish at the World Series. He is having another outstanding season this year. Pat also played basketball for the Generals and was selected first team All-Conference and All-Region. Pat has accepted a baseball scholarship from St. John's University to compete in the Big East Conference next year. Please join me in congratulating Patrick. Congratulations to each of the students and to their families who are recognized this evening. And thank you to the dedicated faculty and staff across campus who support them. And now it is my pleasure to again introduce Megan Bright, Haley Dugan, and Emily Shumsky for a special performance.
If we let them, and we help them in return. a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I've been changed for good. It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. So let me say before we part, so much of me is made of what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a seed dropped by a sky bird in a distant wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for. But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore. Like a comet, like a ship that is a passes by a wind off the sea, like a stream that meets like a sea dot by a bird halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? I do believe I have been changed for the better. And because I knew you, because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed.
It is with pride that I introduce to you the class of 2016. We are here to recognize 508 candidates for associate degrees and 35 candidates for certificate. And this year's class includes 88 graduates who have completed their degrees entirely online through Herkimer College's Internet Academy. To our graduates, congratulations on this significant milestone in your lives. Each of you had goals when you enrolled at Herkimer, whether it was to prepare for a particular career or for continuing your education at a four-year college. During your time here, there is no doubt you have learned valuable skills and achieved a greater awareness of the world. You have learned to overcome obstacles, to be independent, manage your time, and be self-disciplined. And many of you have grown personally through participation in community, cultural, civic, and social activities. Most importantly, you have met your academic goals and prepared yourselves for the future. You and your families have so much to be proud of today. As we look at you, we see future business leaders, educators, healthcare professionals, therapists, counselors, community leaders, scientists, engineers, technicians, accountants, entrepreneurs, artists, musicians, public servants. I could go on and on. The future is yours to create, and Herkimer County Community College has provided you with a solid foundation to go forward and to continue your dreams. On behalf of the entire Herkimer College community, congratulations to the class of 2016 and best wishes in your new endeavors. I would like to ask our Provost, Michael Oriolo, and Dean of Students, Dr. Matthew Hawes, to assist me in awarding diplomas. We do ask that you hold your applause until all diplomas and certificates have been presented. And please note that a professional photographer will photograph each graduate as they accept their diploma. Candidates, please come to the platform as your name is called.
Business Administration AAS, Rhiannon Danielle Steele. Liberal Arts and Sciences General Studies AA, Timothy Vernon McKenzie. Liberal Arts and Sciences Social Science AA, Teddy Joe Cromling. Travel and Events Management AAS, Victor Wayne McCusick. Ocasio Brown. Megan Christine Bright. Haley Michael Dugan. Anastasia Kane. Art Studies AA. Kenwin Gibbs. Business Accounting AAS. Victoria Bayless. Quinaya Matthews. Business Accounting AS. Alicia Buck. Ricardo Carrillo. Yiming Chen. Lindsay Hausman. Regan Janina Sudo. Jared Vibbert. Business Administration AAS. Erica Ball.
Jennifer Grauer. Antonino Magro. Brandon Shoki. Lorraine Thomas. Business Administration AS. Darren Darling. Christina DeSano. Brittany Field. Courtney Legary. Sydney Stanley. Samantha Ward. Fashion Buying and Merchandising AAS. Kayla Barrows Amthor. Caitlin Brown. Mario Hernandez. Amanda Coster. Taylor Lathers. Heather Moore. Kristen Patterson. Alexis Morgan Reed. Coin Spray. Giovanna Works. Matsumi Tauchi. Health Services Management Technology AAS. Melissa Gattuso. Cassandra Palmer. Marketing AAS. Cassandra Daly. Jace LaPuma. Small Business Management AAS. Carissa Cody. Demetrius Moore. Alexis Walters. Sports and Recreation Management AAS. Jaquan Allen. Michael Steven Bartkowiak. Hanifa Charles. Norman Clayton. Flint Anthony Davis Jr. Brandon Inman. Brian Inman. Samantha J. Kendall Jones. Markinson Luktama. Jamar Minto. Christian Mondesur. Janae Musatelli. Brady Plows. Dan Reese. Tyreek Rideau. Dakara Spence. Lauren Thorpe. Kevin Vanderslick. Newton Wilson Jr. Digital Filmmaking AS. He-Man Armstrong, James Daniel Ernst, Luke LaCrosse, Music Industry AS, Chandler Patterson Aldrich, Julian Bell, Jocelyn Callahan, Andre Currents, Brianna Dunn, Katrina Murray, William Poplinski, Yvonne Stevens, Jacob Tower, Radio Television Broadcasting AAS, Carleton Harvard, Jennifer Lopez, Gregory Lessick, Dylan Orlando, Vincent James Salamone III, Computer Network Technician AAS, Anthony Mincarelli, Nicole Oyer, Daryl Sanders, Michael Toomey, Christopher Wood, Computer Science AS, Darren Lawrence, Dan McDonald, Computer Support Specialist AAS, Matthew Doyle, Criminal Justice AAS, Aaron Brown, Jacob Maiden, Edward Wallace, Kyle Uchel, Criminal Justice AS, Leanna Bartlett, Lisa Bennett, Annie Bloomstein, Leslie Daly, Alicia Evans, Canyon Hicks, Sharice Miller, Alicia Owens, Thomas Conrad Paffenroth, Brittany Purcell, Raymond Ruggiero, Dean Schreider, Chanel Shaw, Sam Suarez, Crime and Intelligence Analysis AAS, Elena Reyes, Cybersecurity AS, Lauren Walitska, Forensic Investigations AAS, Christina Armstrong, Brandon Golden, Kayla Hudson, Anthony Montalvo. Kristen Scheidecker. Brandon Thompson. Early Childhood AAS. Lori Bates. Banu Carlisle. Jacinta Patrice Claypool. Alexis Duda. Nicole Alvin. Kristen Dawn Hohall. Ashley Klump. Catherine Keenley. Karen Palmer. Ashley Parker. Caitlin Sharp. Zoe Ray Smith. Silkia Solar. Amanda Thomas. Martinique Farah Torres. Emergency Medical Technician Paramedic AAS. Alyssa Forrester. Victor Coravagna. Fine Arts AA. Sonetta Jones. Xanthian Lincoln. Human Services AAS. Julianne Colby. Andrew Cosme. Taslin DeCobb. Robert J. IKEA D. Pope. James Sheldon. Carrie Smith. Dean Sokolowski. Onika Williams. Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, Childhood Education AS. Allison Nicole Travis. Brianna Urick. Christy Wallace. General Studies AA. Jingjing Ao. Jacob Bakalukas. Maurice Baker. Ryan Balch. Junelle Brazier. Serena Brown. Presley Bryant. Jacob Bunch. Amanda Bush. Tom Callister. Jenna Carlesimo. Nyjah Rebecca Edwards. Willis H. Farnsworth III. Esteban Galvez Ospina. Ensign Garcia. Leah Giacchetta. Stephen Gross. Michael Anthony Hearn II. Devante Huggins. Yu Inose. Paige Jimerson. Samuel Kirsch. Ioi Kano. Kieran Kobayashi. Brittany Loring. Jessica Mashtair. Joshua Mehta. Jordan Mercer. Zoe Alicia Nicole Isaacs. Cassandra Perrone. Hannah Diane Potter. Christopher Reed. Morgan Rudwall. Yu Sasaki. Charlie Simpson. Melissa Ann Sperry. Carolyn Sportello. Marshall Sterling. Yuri Tsuboi. Brian Vasquez. Tonisha Washington. Kaylin Webster. Jung Jung. Humanities AA. Michaela Bintz. Physical Education AS. Alyssa Lepper. Justin Salmon. Science AS. Paul William Greenfield. Justin Maxwell. Corinne Richer. Social Science AA. Carly Allen. Carly Barbanti. Stephen Benzaleski. Caitlin Brown. Kavan Elias. Marcus Galati. Saki Kinoshita. Azumi Homa. Yutahiro Kamimura. Brianna Lawrence. Nicole Lewis. Tanisha McNeil Hayes. Mary Ellen Nicolay. Malik Palmer. Simone Slavic. Clarence Stewart. Lindsay Therian. Megan Whitmoyer. Amanda Widger. Paralegal AAS. Dawn Holub. Chelsea Jory. Kaylin Lowell. Wayne Primo. Rebecca Salvatore. Paige Ward. Photographic Technology AAS. Elizabeth Raji. Physical Therapist Assistant AAS. Misty Anderson. Lexi Armstrong. Jessica Carson. Andrew Sipley. Stephen Kronauer. Erica Dack. Lisa Gardner. Melissa Gilbert. Brittany Hall. Tanya Hayes. Ina Kitchuk. Casey Lee. Lauren Leone. Kimberly Mariotti. Kimberly McMillan. Kelly Moore. Jenna Soper. Marina Steele. Diana Stevenson. Tiandra Twitchell. Kyle Warden. Travel and Events Management AAS. Danae Becker. Gabriella Caruso. Ashley Fox. Marina Ito. Corcoro Matzo. Kyria Plunkett. Emily Rasko. Jardé Reynoso Alcantara. Luba Silver. Medical Coding Transcriptionist Certificate. Ann Hudziak. Emily Lester. Small Business Management Certificate. Georgia Laughlin Lozada. Layla Palick. True Garland. President McColgan, I present the candidates of the graduating class of 2016 for the degree or certificate so listed in this evening's program.
Graduates, please rise. In the name of the trustees and faculty of this college, and by the virtue of the authority vested in me by the trustees and the Chancellor of the State University of New York, I now confer upon each of you individually the degree of Associate in Applied Science, or Associate in Arts, or Associate in Science, or Certificate, with all the rights and privileges that pertain thereto to the candidates here presented. Graduates, and now, as a symbol of the rites of passage, I ask that you move your tassel from the right side to the left side of your mortar boards. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. McColgan, and congratulations. Please be seated and enjoy a very special presentation delivered in spoken word by Timothy McKenzie titled, What a Time to Be Alive.
What a time to be alive. I am going on 21, feeling more lost than when I was age one. Sounds negative and lost, but in all ways, great in all cost. Our generation holds the keys to many doors in front of us. Though stubborn locks can be a process to open, they can result in your life's greatest token. So I guess what I'm trying to say is, when you hit a brick wall, don't fold, because courage and passion is all you need to be bold. African-American civil rights leader Malcolm X once said, I was ashamed to be a criminal, but I would be more ashamed if I stayed a criminal. Now, by all means, I'm not calling none of us a criminal, but let's see the bigger picture. Whatever adversity, stereotype, or situation you have been through, today I am here to say it is no longer a barrier of your success. Therefore, set your goal and make use of every day and every night to achieve it. And as Paul McCartney would say, think globally and act locally, and the world is yours. Thank you.
Thank you, Timothy, for your very insightful and inspirational presentation. Now, please rise for the benediction delivered by Pastor McCusick.
To the class of 2016, I charge you to not repay evil with evil or insult with insult. Remember the community in Herkimer County Community College. Be a part of your communities and work for community. Seek education and life experiences and your calling will find you. And now I share this Irish blessing as the benediction. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. The rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of God's hand. Amen, and go in peace.
To the class of 2016, our congratulations and very best wishes to each one of you. Please join us for a reception in honor of the class of 2016 in the McLaughlin College Center immediately following this program. For safety reasons, we request that you keep the aisles clear and remain in your seats until the recessional is complete. This concludes the 48th annual commencement exercises, and thank you for being with us this evening.
Thank you.